Hello and welcome to another episode of me painting again. Oh yeah, we have the canvas up, we have this picture, but I printed out, I'm not kidding, printed it out ages and ages and ages ago. In fact, it's during the time when I used to print pictures out, I would laminate it and that would give me a shine. So I could mix my colour up and put it on and then wipe it off because it was laminated. Now, I've not done this for about 4 years, I think. So you could tell how long it's been for me to not paint this. And I was looking at what to paint, which is always a thing. What do you paint? What shall I paint? I could go outside, take my paints out, but then it's challenging to film. So I'm probably best off painting something that I've already pre-printed out because I haven't got any printer paper. So then I was looking through my stuff and I found this. And I was like, oh, I still haven't painted that. So let's paint this duck. You know, it's a good time as any. So I think what I'll do, I'll put it on my other easel. And then I'll probably do a quick sketch, bit of a measure, quick sketch with a little bit of paint, and then we'll just go for it. I think it's going to be a fun one, going to enjoy it. So let's get the other angle going. So I've set up my other angle now. So here we are. Good look. Look at the duck. I took this picture while I was crouched down, almost in the lake, and I was messing around with shutter speed and stuff. It's quite a few years ago now. Actually, is when I first got into photography, and I thought, oh yeah, I can use a camera and get my own pictures, and then I won't have to try and ask people for their pictures and stuff. So let's get this show on the road. I think what I'll do, well, let's create some measuring. What I'm thinking is, though, if I move this up here, I might be able to fit this. It's going to make it a bit quicker. So I can go like that. Measure that as well. So you can make a few marks. So you need a mark there. And you've got that sort of shape. So if I sit further back enough, I can actually see the whole thing. That's where the peak is. Something like that, isn't it? And that goes. Can check this one. The eyes. I think the eyes about there, actually. But yeah, we can go back and forth and look at the shape. Maybe I'll measure this bit as well.
Just check the size of that area. Yeah. So maybe we can get started with just that and then work on it. Maybe I can move this up a little bit more. I think I can start there. Okay, so I've got some paints on there now. Some paints. What have we got? I've got some burnt umber, viridian green hue, which, let's be honest, is really phthalo green. Ivory black, chrome yellow, but you could use cadmium yellow or another yellow, cobalt blue. But you could use ultramarine. Some homemade yellow ochre. You know, I made loads of yellow ochre and I forgot about it. And while I was looking for some sellotape, I released my hoard of paints that I made. And I was like, oh, forgot about that. Titanium white. Right. That's the palette of colours. I think that's enough. Might need some red, actually, looking, because there's some feet in the water, there's a little bit orange, so I might just put a tiny bit of vermilion hue over here. So I've just put a little bit of vermilion hue. Start with this brush. Just use one brush to get it going. And the further we get, the more brushes we'll use. But they've just been dipped in this oil and oil of cloves mix and then put on a palette, which is really a plate. But anyway, what does it matter? We can use dirty brushes if we want to use dirty brushes. We're going to mix paint anyway. So I think we're going to start off with the duck colour. Let's go quackers on this one. So some phthalo green and black. Phthalo green. We'll call it phthalo green. It's viridian hue, but it's really phthalo green. So we might as well just call it that, haven't we? So the first colour we need is that there and that there, and this is about right. It might need lightening. See, the reason I stopped laminating is because I can see reflections all over in this printout. It's really annoying. So I'm gonna have to try and ignore. Let's try and get that shape. So the goal of this painting is to make this look like a duck. If it looks like a duck by the end of it, I'm happy. If it doesn't look like a duck, well, something has gone wrong. Try our best to make it duck-like. So I can start with my dark. And then we need to now be nice if we created a light. So a little bit of white in there, look at that. It's got some black in it as well. Let's have a look. Look at how close. So close. So close. So that's a bit there, isn't it? Put that in. A little bit here. Use a bit of that dark colour. Try and kind of dodge where the eye is. Something like that. Not far off. Maybe we should put the beak in as well. Yeah. Could do with some of that watery colour as well. So, sitting back, having a look, I'm thinking the water need this colour. So it's like a greeny grey, isn't it? So maybe some black and brown and some green and some white. Yeah, it's pretty close actually. So I'm gonna make a load of it. Hope you could see that. I forget when I'm filming myself sometimes, I'm just mixing away. So it's brown, green. Too dark because we've added more colour in. So we've got a bit of white in there again. Down. So yeah, throw a little bit more white in it. Yeah, so what the idea was to laminate is so you can do your mix and then you go like that and you can see it on there and then you can check it, and that's really close. It's probably a tiny weeny bit out, but not much, so I usually just go with that because then I can put colour on top of my initial colour if you paint this way. We all paint in different ways. Just zoom in a little bit more. There we go. So I'm going to get this swooped in, I think. Thank you. So I'm just scrubbing the colour in. Gotta watch out for this bit. Colour on thin, and then if you have any problems, then it's easy to wipe off, you see. Or put colour on top. There we go. And then we can just a little bit of light there. Oops. Okay, so need to use a brush. Another brush. So what we want now is a beak brush. Let me get that beak going in. Beak is a yellow. So what I'll do is I'll put some yellow on my brush, which gets rid of the colour that was already on it, and then I can give it a quick wipe. Using my highly expensive blue roll. Really done any painting. I'm gonna run out of paper. Oh well, this is this is how serious I am about painting, you see. I'll live life on the edge. Worst comes to the worst, I've got a few extra pairs of socks. I know, it's a very weird situation we're in at the moment, but gotta keep your sense of humour. Need some black. Oh, that's why. I was going into green trying to get black. All the white while I'm making my brush any darker. Right, let's get some of this yellow. I was going to use chrome yellow for this. Probably a tiny bit too bright. Throwing a bit of yellow ochre in there. It's a tiny bit. If I put a little bit of white in it, I think that'll take... Because white takes away the brightness of the colour. Yeah, that's really close now. Let's just put that on anyway. A little bit of white. Which we need. And then it's got like a... that's close, isn't it? Just put the water on again. Sorry about my arm. And then we've got like a dark bit, sort of black, black at the end, isn't there, a little bit. There's a little bit of upturn, turn up there. So this is where the trouble begins, when the green and the yellow get close. There we go. And I just need to flatten that off there. Just using a bit more of the water. It's a bit of a tinge of red there. Put it in, just for fun. Just sit back, have a look. Check out where the area isn't quite right. That's pretty good. Let's try and do a good job. Yes, let's imagine this is a commission. Let's imagine, I like doing that. Imagining it's a commission from the king of the world. This is the main job for this painter. We have to do it right, otherwise the king will have us. Yeah, I think that'll do to begin with. It's not bad, is it? Now we need to start. I think we need to start putting the front of the body in. So we want like a brown. Just going to move some brushes. Right, I need a sort of this brown, so I use this brush. This is a newish brush, so a bit of brown and white, a bit of umber and white. Needs a bit of black in it. Burnt umber, white and black. Really close, you see. Sit from a distance and look at it. Go. It's about there, isn't it? And it goes. It goes to about there. It's quite dark there. Just get that shape in there. The wing goes there. Okay. I need a little bit of light. This is quite light there. It's light. So back have a look at that end of there. That would be there. Nice. That should be the wall up there. Not far off. We'll go with that. Now we need some of this white, whitey grey. So let's move this a second. So we need. Just gonna throw in some white here. Bit blue probably. And then we've got this grey. Yeah, it's a grey that's almost the colour of the duck. So we need to look at this a bit more. So we've got a piece of what I might do. So grip the eye now. So So it looks like an extra long duck. Try and use that now. So it goes up here. Goes up and then down. There, I can see better now. So let's I'm just changing my colour a bit, white and blue, to get this grey. Started a new pile, just white in the brush mix. So we're pretty close. It's just that mix of white, blue, and a little bit what was on the brush, a bit brown. But then what I've done is I've got some pure white and just made a new mix so it's brighter. It's just a quicker way of doing it to move your brush out into a lighter colour. Can't quite get it cool enough, so I'm going to throw in more blue. Needs grey in a bit, so I just threw in some black. Always almost, I think, so I'll just do it. So it goes. Like that. Make some quick measurements. So it goes to about there. A little bit of a little bit of blue and brown in it to get this done. See how quickly you can get your painting going though. Wipe my brush on a old bit of paper. Gotta try and use it as much as you can. Let's get some of this other colour. So you can, if you use your brush strokes, you can sort of create things within the duck's feathers. You want to make the illusion that there are feathers there, and you can use it by adding paint, sort of almost impasto technique. Well, not almost, it is really, isn't it? By doing it that way, you're adding the paint and you're using the brush strokes to be how do I explain it? You want the brush strokes to be there, basically. You don't want to be there. And use directional strokes and way it almost looks like feathers. All by that simple illusion of painting. Got a bit greyish there. Use a bit more. Area. So with this, we've got sort of a line that we can follow. Yeah, it's more like that. And then we've got that very blue bit. This nice over there, the black bit there. Got this water behind. Maybe we can create the shape using the water actually. So we just need to make a few little measurements here. That goes to there. So that's correct. And then the white goes to there. Yeah, that's correct. this in a bit. I just went and got myself a drink of coffee. So then I can carry on with this. Some more of this colour. It's about right, isn't it? Yeah, it's about right. Check that size. Okay. Yeah, that's not looking too bad. Back to my water. Might fill this in. So whenever I think, not quite sure what to do next, I'll do some of the easy bits. It's a good... It's a good way of doing it. Use a bit of paper just to wipe that out. What I'm thinking. Thinking I might get this bit done. So I might move the whole thing a bit. We sit back, have a look. I'm going to be painting this bit at the back part. part, the back end of the duck. Back end of the duck. So, okay, so I'm thinking I'll put in the black, that black bit there, and these white bits here, and then this black curl there. I've got some water there. So I always think is just start somewhere and then I might even start with a white. Almost. We got that little. Yeah. And we'll put the black in. To use. So we're just picking up black, just picking up the ivory black. Stay sat back so we can get shapes. So the black goes about there. Okay. There. It's black on the underside of that. Let's give these little looks there, and then there's another curly bit that goes whoop there. That's about there, probably. Sit back, have a look at that. Probably need to push this back as well. You can see it's at the back there. See that this is further up as well. But we're getting somewhere, we're getting closer. Okay. Pull that bit out a bit. Just reveal a bit more again. Doing too badly, are we? So we've got this feather area that needs doing. So we need like a light browny colour. Use this brush that I'm using just to take another drink. I just relaxing and painting. Gumping down some nice hot decaf. Grabbing some of this brown, bit of white in it. Probably needs a bit of black in it. So it's just black, brown, and white. Nothing special. There, I think. Strange. So that's about there, about there. Like that. Now I want some of the dark, just brown and black again, just brown and black. Something like that. Just sitting back having a look at this. where our blue bit needs to go. Couldn't quite work it out. It's kind of an important bit, isn't it, that blue bit? So we'll just use the blue we've got and some white. Got a nice piece of blue that goes there. I need the whole thing. Can't quite work out in my head. Yeah, we're okay. That's alright. Pick up a bit of black. I'm gonna get this bit there. Blue looks longer to me. Yeah, it's a couple of lot longer. Clean the old brush. Sit back in here. Well, let me check. Oh, it's alright, I've got time. I always need to check, you see, make sure I've got enough time on the camera. Around, isn't it? Also, this black needs to be further in. Get some light there. Yeah, that's not too bad. Got a little mark there. Put this line. Yeah, we'll leave that. Into the light here. Now we need to start putting in some bits where that needs darkening, bits where there needs to be a bit of light. But I'm quite happy with the way it's looking now. Some more of the lighter colour. Need to put a small brush. I get the eye in. Is quite dark, quite, you know, brown and black, that's what we wanted. Just a little bit of a blob there, isn't it? And then we can get some light. Like going a bit there. Yeah, quite like that. I'll leave that for now. It's a good could quick go at that on this bit here. Okay, and there's a using this brush, there's this bit here that goes. See if we can get that in. Something like that. I think my duck's a bit bigger. No, it's about the same actually. It's not too bad then. Let's go with this bit. Need that, need to stop looking at the water. sort of reflecting things, I think. So have another quick drink. So I thought I'd finish my drink and then I'd be ready to do more. So we're gonna start looking at this area, the water. So putting in some of this colour, a bit lighter there maybe, is it? A bit lighter there. Duller in this bit, so I'll dull this bit. Got this black there. Bringing it across. Goes to about there. There's a bit of a strip. No, there's a bit there. There's a bit of blue in lot. Need to do more flatter strokes there. It's quite dark under this bit. So it has to go quite dark. Black and brown, black and brown. Black now and I'm trying to give it the impression of what's there. I'm not going to get it exact. The more you do this, the more you start seeing other things as well. Like I can see a bit of white that we missed. Well, I say we. Me. Okay, get our water brush again. Some white that we need to put in the water as well. Around there, which is below this. A bit of a bluey, browny tone to mine. I'll go with that, I'm not too fussed. A little bit of red and yellow. Not bad. Go with that. About there, isn't it? Shh. Yeah, it's not too bad. Oops. I think we need to look at the other side. Oh, I've got paint all over me. Does happen. Not quite far enough on that, is it? Something like that. Okay, that's quite good. What I could do with doing the water in a few of those places. So when I sit back, I can see that this is a bit taller than it should be. It's a bit better. Okay. Well, we wanted to have a look at the other side, didn't we? So like it's a long time since I've seen this part of it. It's not bad. It's not bad. It's not exactly the same. But it'll do me. It'll do me. So I need to drag out some of the Sometimes my biggest problem is stopping the painting from falling over. Some yellow in the water you can just about make out. I think what I might start doing is throwing in some of the colours, like these colours. Be nice to see in the water. Which is, I think it's that. Yeah, that's close. That is, I'll just drop everything. Chrome yellow mixed in with a bit of iridium green, a bit of brown, a bit of white. Gets it really close anyway. So let's see if we can just throw in a few of these bits while we're sat back. Now it's going to blend away a bit, so we might have to mix. I mixed a fair bit more. A little bit brighter because it's going to disappear a bit. So Oh, I don't seem to have any colour down there. Whoops. There we go, that's better. Right, back to this colour. Some sort of indication of the beak in the water there. It's just so I can see more of it. Just so I don't even lose light, I put my light on. Because that has happened to me before. I was happily painting and then I lost light. Forgot to can see a sort of a post there. Let's put that in. Throwing in different areas that are a bit darker. Making some minor changes in the water. Just move that so it's all in. That's all in the frame. So we've also got these water droplets as well. Let's splash. Looking at my duck, its head is that's probably better. Anyway, let's try and get some of these a bit dark. What I'm going to do, I'm going to use just little indications of it. Where is it? Is it line with that? Little indications of the and they kind of reflect. Makes it more fun to be there as well. Just sit back, have a look at that. Back, have a look at that. Yeah, I quite like that. That's quite nice. That is quite nice. Just need to lighten a few of these areas. Just throwing in some sort of indications of okay, just sit back, have a look at that. Yeah, I quite like that. Well,
I might do. I need to get that dot in there. Sort this dark underside of the
Yeah, I think we'll call that. That looks like a duck in the water, having a bit of a splash.
I quite like it.
You can always see things that you think, oh, I could do that, I could do that. But I think I'll call this one finished. I say finished. I see something. A little bit more white, pure white. On some of these droplets. Yeah, let's call that. Otherwise, I think I'll end up painting and painting and painting. Yeah, so thanks very much for watching this episode. Bit of a fun duck painting that, you know, with a bit of time, you could do. I'll just give it a little JB there. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I look at it and I go, oh, I could do this. Oh, I could do this. Looks a bit more alive now. So I can always, see more and more. But I think I'll stop now. So I'd like to say thank you very much for watching this episode. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it gave you some ideas in this period of time. If you are stuck at home, then maybe get the paints out. Enjoy yourself while you've got your easel set up. and your paint's ready, and I'll be making sure I get my paints out and isolate myself as much as I can, which is difficult because I work at a supermarket and we've still got to put our stock out, so that's going to be a challenge. It's been a challenge so far and it will continue to be a bit of a challenge, but I'm not going to worry, I'm just going to stay concerned about it all. So enjoy your painting, and I'll see you in another episode. Cheers, bye.